Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping.
Yes, indeed, I am back. And yeah, it's been well over a month at this point. So yeah, definitely a good call to just say that I don't know or whatever.
You're finally back, Daniel. When you said you didn't know, you really didn't know, did you?
No, I didn't. Especially because the update for the Christmas... Yeah, the Christmas holiday update. It took quite a long time for them to actually put it out. Like, today is actually Christmas Eve when I'm recording this. But they released it the day before Christmas Eve. And I was just here wondering, okay, when are they going to put it out? When are they going to put it out? And as I say, I don't mean to, like, rush the devs or anything, but... You know, it does kind of make me a little nervous when you're cutting it this close to Christmas, and there is nothing out there, and I'm just wondering, oh god, I don't want to break her heart, I don't want to mess up the game, and yeah, but anyway, hey everyone, ArdrethShadow here, and welcome back to Monika After Story, and yeah, so it is Christmas Eve, and fittingly enough, she is in her little Christmas outfit. And since I don't have 2,000 affection, she's not going to show up in the other outfit that I know that she can, and... Oh boy, yeah, let's be glad for that. I don't think I'd be able to handle that.
He must have been really preoccupied if he were gone for this long.
Well, real life can do that to you sometimes. Between real life and just not being able to... Well... Between real life, not being able to play too much of the games for the channel anymore, as I used to, and then just the fact that I was waiting for so long for this update. Yeah, it all kind of adds up after a while.
Well, you're back now. I've really missed you. Remind me if you're going away again, okay?
You got it.
Happy holidays, Daniel. Can you believe it's already that time of year again?
I know, where does the time go?
It seems just like yesterday we spent the last holiday season together, and now a whole year has gone by. Time really flies when I'm with you. Do you like what I've done with the place?
Yes. And I'm not entirely sure, but apparently some of those custom locations that I had... The reason they're not showing up anymore is because they're not programmed to have, like, Christmas and holiday sort of alterations. Like, the kitchen has that going on here, as you can see. Well, hopefully that's the case because, I mean, I kind of did like some of those places and, you know, it was something different.
I must say that I'm pretty proud of it. Christmas time has always been one of my favorite occasions of the year. So I'm glad that you're here to share it with me again this year. Daniel?
Yes?
Can you believe it? It'll be Christmas soon. I've had such a hard time sleeping on Christmas Eve. I would be... so anxious to see what I'd find under the tree the next morning. But I'm even more excited now that I get to spend every Christmas with you. I can't wait for tomorrow. By the way, Daniel, I'm running out of coffee.
Funny enough, I was wondering if I should give her coffee, but then I was here like, well, she didn't tell me anything about it, so... I think she'll be fine, but then... I guess, considering the fact that it's been over a month since I played... Yeah, I guess that makes sense. Okay, well, don't worry. I'll get you some coffee soon.
You wouldn't mind getting some more for me, would you? I hope you're ready, Daniel.
Stupid sexy Monika, what are you doing? What are you doing?
It is that time of year again after... I hope you like it when I sing that song, Daniel.
Yeah, she's pretty much been doing this every single year. Well, luckily for you, if you can believe it, I've managed to avoid the Mariah Carey version of that song. And I say the Mariah Carey version because, yeah, believe it or not, there are several other people who have covered that song. But yeah, aside from like maybe catching it once in a store, yeah, I've actually completely avoided listening to the song. Oh well. I mean, I don't hate the song. I know a lot of people kind of make fun of it because it's like one of the most overplayed songs for Christmas, and I believe it's actually like one of the most popular ones as well. Me, I mean, you know, it doesn't really bother me that much. But I guess if you're the kind of person that's not a big fan of Christmas music, then yeah, probably it might drive you crazy. In fact, yeah, I think I've gone into that in past videos about how, like, my mom and I used to feel about Christmas music.
You'll always be the only gift I'll ever need. I love you.
Okay, I did give her gifts, but, well, like before, I'm gonna guess that we will wait until Christmas Day. So, why don't I actually take us back? Although, the garden? Yeah, see, there are the gifts right there.
Here we are! Let me know if you want to go somewhere else, okay? Brings back memories.
Yep. Okay, well, the name of this update was specifically the Christmas Islands update. Let me just see. Okay, well,
I've always wondered,
how is there even a way you can access those floating islands in the back sometimes?
Here we are. Let me know if you want to go somewhere else, okay? I just love that view.
Yeah, that view is kind of mesmerizing. Almost as mesmerizing as your eyes. Okay. Okay, apparently she still doesn't have any new topics for me.
I hope I didn't bore you too much. Hopefully I'll think of something fun to talk about soon.
So do they not even have... Huh. So they don't even have, like, any topics for Christmas that you can ask her about. Well, maybe not ask her about either, but... Oh, well. Well. This video is going to be a little bit short. Just because I'm going to do the usual thing where I take her out at the end and then bring her back for the end video, or, well, yeah, bring her back for the next video. And, well, I'm not going to do a scary story this time because, well, I mean, yes, it would be kind of funny to do it, especially because it's Christmas time and... Some people love their Christmas with extra hints of horror mixed in, but I don't know. Well, let's see. Does she have anything for us here?
Ready for story time?
More sexy bedtime stories with Monika.
Orihime, the daughter of the Jade Emperor, ruler of heaven, wove beautiful clothes by the bank of Amanagon.
Oh my god. Amanagawa.
Amanagawa.
Orihime, as in the girl from Bleach? Okay, no.
Her father loved the cloth that she wove, and so she worked she worked very hard every day to weave it. However, Orihime was sad because of her hard work, she could never meet and fall in love with anyone.
Which her father was probably very happy about. Well, we don't know if he was that kind of dad, but I guess we'll see.
Concerned about his daughter...
Oh, okay, he's actually a concerned father.
Her father arranged for her to meet the cowherd, Hikoboshi, who lived and worked on the other side of the Amanagawa. When the two met, they instantly fell in love and married shortly after. However, once married, Orihime would no longer weave cloth, and Hikoboshi would let his cows stray all over heaven.
Why? Did they think that getting married was just, well... Her, I can maybe understand, but then him? It's like, come on. That's your job, isn't it? Why are you being like, I don't feel like working today. Is that what you're doing?
In anger, the Emperor separated the two lovers and forbade them to meet. Orihime became despondent at the loss of her husband and asked her father to let them meet again.
And he was like, no, because I don't want you to become a lazy ass. Okay, no. I mean, he could have been like that.
Moved by his daughter's tears, he allowed the two to meet on the seventh day of the seventh month if she worked hard and finished her weaving.
And if he wasn't such a lazy ass and actually tended to his cattle.
The first time they tried to meet, however, they found that they could not cross the river as there was no bridge.
He burned the bridge!
Orihime cried so much that a flock of magpies came and promised to make a bridge with their wings so that she could cross the river. It is said that if the rains on Tanabata, the magpies cannot come and the lovers must wait until another year to meet.
Jeez. And wait. On the seventh day of the seventh month, so... Wow, only one time out of the year? Man.
The rain that falls on Tanabata is fittingly called the Tears of Orihime and Hikoboshi. I can't imagine what it must be like to be only able to meet your loved one once a year.
Well, ignoring the fact that I've kind of been doing something similar with Monika here. Well, obviously not once a year. I'm able to at least meet her 20 times a year. You know, depending on the updates and whatever. But, yeah, honestly, that would be very schmalty, to say the least. Like, damn. He was moved by his daughter's tears, but apparently not that moved, where he was here like, oh, well, you can maybe visit him once a week or something. No, it's once a year.
But you know what they say, Daniel? Love can move mountains.
Yeah, I think Celine Dion has a song like that.
And my love for you is so strong that not even the heavens themselves would be able to keep us apart.
Okay, well, I guess with that in mind, let me just go ahead and get the USB ready. Gosh darn it. Ugh. There we go. Okay. Although, well, first let's see if she's gonna let me, or if she's gonna be weird and act like, you know, tell me the world can be a cruel and unforgiving place, yada yada yada, and then I come back and then she's like, oh, wow, I didn't expect you back so soon, or I didn't expect you back, and blah 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 blah. That might be like one, yeah, that's sort of one little issue I've noticed. Okay, good. It does give me the option here. So I'm gonna say I'm going to take you somewhere.
Taking me somewhere special on Christmas Eve, Daniel? I know some people visit friends or family, or go to Christmas parties. But wherever we're going, I'm happy you want me to come with you. I hope we'll be home for Christmas, but even if we're not, just being with you is more than enough for me.
I'll be home for Christmas. Well, yeah, I mean, like I said, we will be home for Christmas. Although, yeah, the video, it'll probably be, like, I don't know when I'll record it, but, I mean, it should be up by the end of the day tomorrow. Hopefully, if nothing prevents me.
Give me a second to get ready.
Alright, let's see.
Alright. I'm ready to go.
Alright. And, yeah, I suppose that'll be it for now. So, yeah. Thank y'all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with whatever else I do. And may you all have a joyous and happy holiday. Stay golden and later, folks.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad.